well, almost 2 years, and you know, the whole industry kind of went down, and it's great that live music and theatre's back, and it's even better to be back in Cardiff and actually performing in front of an incredible Welsh audience here.
I was just saying to some of the other cast members, it's just nice to restore your identity a little bit. You know, I think it's been a challenging 2 years, let's say, for everyone, for most people. But it's nice to be around cast members again that are a bit more lighthearted and kind of have some fun and just, as I said, restore identity and create a really fun show for kids and for adults.
I've been working now since back in end of June, was it? It started, opened up again. I do DJ stuff as well now on my own. Was a meet and greet I did after a DJ spot, but that's out the window now, obviously, until COVID is eased a bit more, because you know, you don't know where you're going to cash it, do you? That's the trouble with it now, this. But so now I do an hour's DJ set and they love it, and it's great to see all that warmth coming back.
Absolutely amazing. We just can't believe it. We can't believe it. This is my first panto. Yep, my first one. I rehearsed last year to do one, and we did the whole week, 2 weeks of rehearsing, and then it closed on the day that it was supposed to open because of our wonderful friend.
I have a real passion for doing panto in Cardiff. Obviously, I'm Welsh. Cardiff is the capital. But I think what makes it so special is that I feel like I just have a connection with the audience. You know, I think you have this generational thing in panto, as everybody knows. And a lot of the people who are coming to Cardiff Panto have either seen me playing for Cardiff, seen me playing for Wales. And I just think they kind of enjoy this transition of, you know, because with panto, it's very much tongue-in-cheek. And people are like, well, hang on now, how can this rugby player go from being on stage doing pantomime? And I think there's this kind of this expectation to come and be okay about laughing, because when you talk about rugby players or sports people going into panto, the first thing people do is laugh. So it's kind of like, well, you're laughing before I've even opened my mouth and said anything. So there's this kind of hook there with that, and I enjoy that. I enjoy the fact that, you know, there's a sense of, like, I was very serious when I played rugby, and now my life is completely different. I'm a completely different person, and we can enjoy it. Yeah. We can laugh about that. So I think the connection I have and the connection they have with me is one of, like, being able to have fun. I've always kind of felt very passionate about what I've done, and I've always felt that I'm not afraid to show that passion. So people through my rugby or through my life in general have been let in to so much about my life. So, you know, I'm almost kind of like a relative, if you want, for want of a better word, to so many people. So it's, you know, it's kind of coming and being excited about going to see someone you already know doing something that maybe you don't expect them to do, and you're excited to see what they can deliver or how they can do it. So yeah, I very much feel like, you know, for me again, you know, being in Wales, anywhere in Wales, or especially in Cardiff, that, like, I'm performing in front of a people who I've probably known or have known me for, like, probably the best part of 20, maybe 30 years, you know?
This Jasmine, yeah, she's a bit feistier. She's got a feisty side. So it's the traditional story of Princess Jasmine and Aladdin, but I think for me and my character, I get to really connect with the younger audience. I do keep it quite pure and quite straight as much as I can, and from Aladdin's that I've done before, I think my role as princess is just to kind of keep that element of fantasy, you know, not to get lost in everything that's going on, all the jokes for the adults and all the craziness. So yeah, so I'm excited just to kind of tap into that magical fantasy world, especially for the little kids as well, you know.
Oh, I'm so glad you made it, but next time, I'll sneak into the palace to see you.
We have to be careful. If my mom catches us, she says she's going to throw you in the tunnel of doom.
Oh, I'll gladly die for you, Jasmine.
But then we wouldn't be able to get married.
I didn't think of that.
And then you wouldn't be able to kiss me.
You mean like this?
Yeah.
This is my 12th Panto, only the second time I've ever played Aladdin. So yeah, it feels great to be back. Yes, it is extremely odd when you see your face on a bus, but yeah, it's all part and parcel of it. Every Christmas, there's literally nothing that I'd rather be doing. You know, I'm so used to doing Panto now that it's, as soon as I start rehearsals for Panto, it's only then that it starts to feel like Christmas. My daughter as well, she's 12 and she loves watching Daddy and Panto, so she'll be down here lots. Yeah, watching me do my thing.
Well, when we got the break onto Chuckle Vision with the BBC, we were doing a children's show, which was Roger the Dog, Ward Allen, and we hadn't. We said when they asked us to do it, we said we've never worked with kids. You know, we're not a kids act, because we weren't. We worked clubs, nightclubs, everything. And they said, yeah, but you do pantomime every year. We said, yeah, we do panto. They said, well, if you come, do your little gags that you do in panto, and it'll be fine. And we did it. We enjoyed it. But we went to Ashton-under-Lyne. Thameside Theatre, and there was 28 people in. I think it was about eight mums and about 16 kids or whatever that was there. And we were going, you shouldn't have to go out this. It's 1,300 seater theatre and you've got 28 people in. But they said, yeah, but they brought them all down the front. We said, oh, thank you. So what we didn't know was that the producer and director of the Roger the Dog Show, BBC, was sitting at the back watching the show. We had no idea they were in. And we went on and just enjoy it. Dad always used to teach us before he was George and started the business, always give it 100%. You know, just because there's 28 people and not 1,000, they've all paid the same money. If they all paid £10 each, 1,000 would have paid £10 each. So it's not their fault, there's only 28.
Yeah.
So we always did. So we went out and we banged it out, and Barry kept running down the steps and trying to sit with the crowd. And I said, get back up here. And he said, it's better down here than it is up there. We're just enjoying ourselves. And the audience loved us. And we got a phone call the next day from, Peter Risdale Scott from the BBC. And I said, oh yeah, who is it? Thought it was a mate winding up, you know. He said, this is Peter Risdale Scott from the BBC. And he said, we came and saw the show yesterday. We said, oh no, it was dreadful, 28 people. And he said, no, we loved the way you worked. If you can work to 28 people in a theatre, that's all you get in a studio with the cameras, lighting, sound, makeup. You know, you work perfectly. So we said, oh, yes, of course we did. So anyway, they invited us over lunch and it's all gone on from there, so.
These guys are great. Alfie's amazing. Widow Twanky Mike Doyle, what a legend. I've known him for so many years, so many. We've cruised together for over 20 years, which is great. I mean, you know, so you get to work with your friend. And everybody brings a different dynamic to it, you know? And I mean, I'm the Empress, so I am very real. And I do tolerate you. If you step out of line, I'm coming for you. Okay? That so isn't me. You know, everything me is joke, 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 joke. So every 5 minutes is... Okay. I am the Empress. Sort yourself out.
Panto, as I've realised, it's not just about what we do on the stage, it's how we get the audience to be a part also of what we're doing on the stage. And over the years, what I've kind of realised was that kids of people who I were playing rugby with were maybe too young to come, you know, 5-6 years ago. But now my mates are coming and they text me to say, I'm going to come and see you in Panto. And it's not kind of nerve-wracking because, again, people might not see this, but it's the reality is that people think that professional sport is completely different to pantomime being on stage, and it isn't. If you take the stage and you convert that into a pitch and you have an audience and you're on that stage to take the audience kind of on a journey with you, to make them laugh, to make them happy, to make them like understand what's going on in the show, and at the end make them leave feeling like they've, you know, been fulfilled, like they've had their money's worth. It's very similar to what rugby players do. It's exactly what we do. Probably where Panto then and rugby differs is that the rugby has the element of the unknown. You know, you don't really know what the result is going to be. Whereas in Panto, you know, the really hard work, what we're doing now within rehearsals, the really hard work has kind of been done to create a product that we are all very confident that when the audience leave, they leave with a smile on their face. They leave feeling like they've had value for money. They feel like they've been entertained. So I suppose that's the biggest difference. And that actually then is something that gives me a sense of kind of feeling like I'm okay about being in Panto, because I know that I can, you know, when you're sitting in the change rooms and you can hear the crowds outside and they're all anxious and wondering what's going to happen, in my changing rooms I'm not nervous, because I'm kind of thinking to myself, you know what, I know what's going to happen. I know what I'm going to hear you saying when you leave this.
It's a real art form, you know, and, you know, it's completely different to anything else I do. However, it's just so much fun. We have a laugh on stage, and we invite the audience to have a laugh with us. And, you know, I think that's the art of it. There's a fantastic show that we're putting together here. The songs are great. The cast are really, really fantastic. I get to fly on a magic carpet over the audience, you know, so that's a real treat as well. You know, I watched Panto as a kid, and I dreamt of playing the prince, or dreamt of playing Aladdin when I was a kid. You know, so it's still very much a pinch yourself moment, you know, every time you kind of walk on and you're playing this iconic role, you know. And yes, it introduces kids to theatre, you know, there's a big responsibility there, but we all step up to the mark, and it's really fantastic.
Hello!
Hello!
Hang on, Mum. What are you doing with the microphone?
Hey, I'm going to get the Empress's good books, and I'm going to do a free concert in the palace grounds.
What are you laughing at? You can't sing.
I can.
You can't.
I can.
You can't.
I can.
You can't.
You can't.
I can.
You can't.
I can.
You can't.
I can.
You can't.
You don't know what you're talking about.
I do.
You don't.
I do.
You don't.
But you don't.
I do.
You don't.
I do.
You don't.
For a start, you can't sing looking like that.
Why not?
Well, you don't look like a pop star, do you?
Oh.
Nowadays you've got to look like a pop star, you see.
Oh,
you're halfway there, you walk. I tell you what, I'll help you out. Go and get changed, make yourself look more like one. Come back here, sing your song, I'll tell you you're going wrong and I'll put you right.
Oh, thanks, son.
Mum. Yes, where are you going?
Well, you told me to go and get changed.
Yes, I didn't tell you to go now, did I?
Oh, sorry.
Now you can go.
Oh, thank you.
Mum.
Yes, sir.
You won't be long, will you? she's lovely, my mum, isn't she? You know. Oh, hello.
The first pantomime I did that year, when he died in August, and I went to do pantomime walking with the bad guy from Strictly. And I was standing at the side of the stage waiting to go on, and the first time I've ever been on stage without anybody else, because it's always been Barry. 1963 we started the business, and we worked, you know, as a double act. I never walked out on stage on my own, and I was going to walk out to do our opening routine on my own. And I swear I saw Barry standing opposite me waiting to go on. And it picked me up. And as I walked out on stage, the house erupted, you know, fabulous cheers. People have been really nice to me, you know, since he died and what have you. And from that right there on, he's always been there. I've always had the confidence to go out and do it, you know, and it's been a journey, as they say nowadays.
Sugar.
I've realised that theatres are a big part of cities, they're a big part of towns, and they need support. So we want to put on a good show to entertain people, to get people to come. Yes, for many reasons, but I think as well for a reason that the new theatre in Cardiff is iconic. Like a Cardiff, you know, without a new theatre wouldn't be a Cardiff. So I think the theatres were hit massively over it. So I think it's really important that we put a good show on to get people back in, to get people confident about going back into the theatre, to get people, you know, going back into the theatre and leaving the theatre thinking, oh, I've missed moments like that in my life. You know, I really have, and it's good to have them back.
Only rivers flow to the sea, to the open arms of the sea. Lonely riverside, wait for me, wait for me. I'll be coming home, wait for me.
I actually performed the first ever song I released on Chair Melody, and it's a real kind of beautiful moment between myself and Jasmine in the show. So that's something to look forward to. Yeah, my daughter will be here. All my family are coming down from Yorkshire, which is really fantastic. And I've got friends here as well in Cardiff, so I'm actually staying with them for the whole time. So it's a full-on friends and family affair.
I'm staying in Penarth on a marina. So I open my shutters every morning and a little boat passes by and I think, this is amazing. It's absolutely wonderful. Everybody's friendly, everybody's chatty, everybody wants to talk to you. What more do you want? You've got the castle, that's beautiful. And that lovely big ferris wheel. Oh, it's magical. It's really magic. It's a beautiful place. I'm gonna come more often.
Oh, it's beautiful, it's my first time. So, I was a bit nervous because in a way for me, it's also a different culture that I'm experiencing. I'm from Hong Kong, by the way. So we have pantomime, but it's not to this level, not to this kind of big spectacular level. And I know that in Cardiff, people are really, they kind of have that tight-knit connection with that time of the year. And I can feel it already just walking around. I can just kind of feel the Christmas love already. So that's really nice. And people are so friendly. People are delighted to know there's a pantomime happening again. So, yeah.
It looks really nice, yeah. I mean, going back to where I'm staying and the fairground and all that, is that just there for the winter, Christmas? Mm-hmm. Looks superb. And we've always said when we used to do the clubs down here in the 60s, those beautiful white council buildings, wherever they are, they're beautiful, aren't they? Mind you, it is the capital city, isn't it? So it should be.